Well, next up, we got another absolute belting world title fight, okay? But it's the very first ever transatlantic cross-promotion world title fight. Never been done before,
it's
the first time. Between Chad Kelly, who's from America, he's from Ohio, and he fights for BYB, and he's taking on our very own Anthony Holmes, who's the middleweight champion. And, well, we caught up with Anthony a little while ago.
Quite confident in my ability. I'm quite tough as well. I've never really been wobbled or, you know, hurt during a fight. I do think I've still got another gear. I'm quite physical, I'm fit, and I can put most of the unfuck to shame. Yeah. Plus I've got the experience now as well, the older head, and I'm, like I said, I don't think there's a young pup that can keep up with me on the physical side anyway. He's very aggressive, a little bit more raw on the boxing side, but he still has got like certain little angle shifts, comes leading in quite a lot, and he's in your face constantly. I've not really dealt with that much pressure before, so I find it interesting. I'm looking forward to it, like.
Were you that relaxed, Robin Reed, in World Title Fights?
No. No, it was. I mean, once you've done all the training, Tom, and the preparation, you can soon focus your mind to, you know, you know what you've done, you know what you're going to go out and do. You know, there's no point in worrying about it or getting nervous months before the fight or whatnot. So, he was quite calm and relaxed, and that's a good way to be, confident in himself, you know, and why not?
And I think what you do in training
reflects on what
it makes you confident, because if you've been through a proper camp,
exactly,
and you're fit, you know
as a fighter, and if you've done the work, if you've
missed out on the road work, you might not be quite so confident.
Exactly.
Absolutely. Let's have a little look. We caught up with the fighters today at the weigh-in.
Presents the first ever cross promotion world championship title clash. Anthony Holmes versus Chad Kelly.
I'm always picking new stuff up. I'm more disciplined than I've ever been since I've been back fighting.
Honestly, it doesn't matter to me, man. All the people I care that care about me winning are back home. So, and you go somewhere, nobody knows you, you get new fans there. That's how it works.
I leave no stone unturned. I'm just move like I can move. I know I'm capable of it. In top quality, so I'm not under no illusion I'm invincible, but I'm more than prepared for this shit.
And then into Dwayne, I want to stop the fight early, obviously, but I can go the whole time if I need to.
I can mix it power, straight, you know, I can battle, I can box, so I'm just looking forward to it.
Wow, two great fighters in great nick.
Great shape
there. I thought I was looking in the mirror for a minute.
Put me to shame, mate. I put my top back on.
To be fair, Anthony's give that some bit some stick, hasn't he?
Yeah. He's got a body to put the tan on, and to be fair. But yeah, he's looking in great shape. He's confident. The American, to be honest.
The American's quietly
Chad
confident.
Kelly, yeah, quietly confident.
I spoke to Mike, the governor of BYB, and he said, this guy, he said, he comes forward, and he was, he beat Carlos Lopez, he says, who was unbeaten, and he just came in and destroyed him. So, and I actually made the point, I said, look, we don't want that belt going anywhere.
Yeah.
We want it here. And I said, everybody in this place is going to hate you.
He's quite calm.
Yeah, he's quite calm.
Considering, like he said, he's in another country, he's open to make more fans for free, you know, on his performance and that. So
he said, I've got a lot of friends watching
in America.
I'm fine to be in America, so happy days. You know, he's got
more fans here. So he's got the right attitude. He's not giving it the big in, you know, the big brash. You know, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. He's just said it as what he sees it's going to be. Quite calm, quite cool. And we'll see what he brings to the table.
You know, you look at, I mean, Dan Lerwell, who you've just seen lose, he beat Dan Lerwell, Anthony Holmes, to get the title. And he'd beat Ryan Barrett before. You've seen Ryan Barrett tonight. He'd beat Martin Shaw, Mason Shaw. So he's actually beaten two
good
guys. The MMA record for Chad Kelly, 4-3, and 1 no contest. I find out what that's about.
He's
a BYB fighter. He beat Carlos Lopez, knockout third round in March this year. So he's been, you know, this is going to be another great fight, by the way. This is going to be another absolute belting fight.
All fighters are beginning to wait the way to the ring now, both quite well.
To be confident. I'm actually boring myself now about every fight's a great fight, but it is, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah. And you know what we've seen? We've seen the whole range of fights.
We've seen different styles, boxers.
We've seen the two technical boxers. We've seen every sort of fight you can have.
Yeah.
But one thing is common denominator. Warriors.
Yeah, exactly. They fight to, you know, the
courage.
They fight.
Warriors.
They fight to, they fight the heart. So, you know, they want to be taken out of there on the shields on them. You know, some bad cuts and wounds to the face, but they still carry on.
Here we
and
go.
They don't want to be stopped.
Brilliant. Let's cross to our ring announcer, Lance Miller.
Up next, ladies and gentlemen, in our co-main event of the evening, we make bare knuckle history. The first ever cross-promotional world title clash. Allow me to introduce, first of all, to the blue corner, all the way from the USA, Chad Kelly.
Chad Kelly is 33, is 6 foot. BYB is 1-0. He's from Bellefontaine in Ohio. That's where he was born. He's living somewhere else now, but that's where he's from. That's his hometown. And he's known as the Butcher.
That's interesting.
Yeah, not very nice. But he's got something about, you know, when you look at somebody and you get the awesome sort of big grin in your face and you don't say nothing.
No, it's just quiet.
I call him like the quiet assassin.
Yeah. He's got the he's in a different country, you know, on his own as such, but he's not got his own crowd behind him. He's still got a bit of confidence. I used to like being the underdog, me.
But no, that might inspire him.
It did me.
Everybody hates me and I don't care.
Yeah, I was the same.
Italy,
Germany, Ireland.
Back to Lance Murdoch.
And next, allow me to introduce his opponent into the red corner, Anthony Holmes.
Anthony Holmes, 36, he's 5'10". 3-0 from Castleford, another image of the Gladiator. And as I said earlier, the beat Dan Dale, knocked him out of the third round to get this world middleweight crown. He beat Ryan Barron, unanimous decision, beat Brian and Mason Shaw, unanimous decision. And the guy's got a great record, but he's confident, he's fit, he trains like a demon. And he'll go, he can go 10 rounds.
It's hard to keep it.
Because everybody sees you as a big scalp.
And then how you were looking at it, everybody was looking at you while you were looking at the at winning that one time. Every person in the fight of life's got that same hunger. But you had when you won the world title, so it's...
Let's go back to Lance, who's going to get them together.
Ladies and gentlemen, BKB and BYB present 7 2-minute rounds of bare knuckle boxing in this world middleweight title clash. Introducing first, in the blue corner, the challenger representing Ohio, USA, with a BYB record of 1 fight and 1 win, Chad the Butcher Kelly. Across the ring, his opponent stands in the red corner, representing Castleford, with an undefeated BKB record of 3 fights and 3 wins, Anthony the Gladiator Holmes! Clive Allison is in charge of the action.
Okay, both leaving rules are right, 7-2s, watch the heads when you're coming in. If you're in close, expect you both to be working. No holding and striking, all right? If they break, you stop, you take one step. Either one of you goes down, either immediately neutral corner. Good luck, lads.
Let's get down to business.
See, in America, they allow clinching.
Now,
it's whether or not when he's in the heat of the battle, whether he forgets that he's not allowed to here. Positive quick start.
The genius money going on there, Tom.
Yeah.
The Andrew Holmes happened.
Both fighters look really focused. Oh, good shot. But then why does he duck into it? Yeah, but throws the punch and ducks into it, which is almost looking for the right upper to get it.
There's his uppercut. That's what he was saying. Good draw in there. Be careful of that over and right hand.
Right, it's wild, isn't it?
He wants
a tear up, doesn't he? Chad.
Nice uppercuts coming in from Andy Holmes all on the inside. Boxing nice. Using his counterpunch skills, drawing his man in.
Oh, he's changing stance now, yep.
Trying to get reaction out of his man, make a mistake.
Oh, good shot.
And then come back with that counterpunch.
Oh, slip there, he went out the ring. That was a slip.
Yeah, that was a slip.
Changing stats, that's a nightmare for the opponent,
yeah,
isn't
that's
it?
The idea, you, Tom, yeah, you're right, it's a nightmare for him. He doesn't know what's coming at him. Are you going to lead with the right?
From Holmes.
Are you going to lead with the left? Yeah, Holmes boxing nice here, Tom. He's using his brain well. Picking his shots nice.
Oh, they're throwing punches out.
That's a cut. Kelly sustained there, Tom.
Yeah, right at the end.
I don't know where it is, but...
It's right on the bridge of the nose, by the look of it. Yeah, it is.
Pretty heavy.
It's right on the bridge. Look, see? The blood's coming down the nose. As long as it doesn't go into the eye, let's have a look back. All three judges have gone for Holmes.
It was nice work from him.
Yeah, absolutely. Good
work
from him.
Get involved in the scrap. I mean, it's getting, you know, his opponent gets near, he ties him up, moves off, gets himself out of the way, and gets back on the back foot, waiting for the counter punches.
Well, the medics have had a look at that cut, and he keeps blinking, so.
And if it's in the eye, Tom,
it's a problem.
He's blinking every day.
They haven't stopped the bleeding by the look of it.
Andy Holmes just finishing them encounters with the final punch.
Oh, up and under. Oh, great.
Almost catches the judge's eye.
Yeah, a lovely upper from Holmes there. He's got hunting, hasn't he, now? Holmes, he can smell a wind, you know.
Yeah. And it's a lot of blood coming from that cut, Tom, and it's heavy as well. Holmes, is that
I think he's seen cut as well, or is that from, Kelly?
Okay.
I think he's cut himself.
It's under the eye.
It's under the eye, which is always good to move away. Is that out of his nose as well? I think it's out of his nose as well.
So Holmes has sustained a bit of damage himself,
yeah.
Tom. Is he having trouble breathing there?
That's
his nose is having the mouth open.
Let's go! all went home for the first round.
He's going in a straight line, trying to change the angles. It's nice to see he's not just wading in, hoping for the best. He's jabbed to the body. He's just moving just out of the way now.
Good body shot again.
Good body shot. Two good body shots though. He's claiming low there. They were low. They were right. Well, he should be thrown right on the belt.
Oh, over here. Good feet. Good work. Getting to get out of the way.
Good footwork from Holmes. Get himself out of the way. Off to the sides. Nice footwork. Holmes.
A lot of blood pouring out of that nose or mouth. I can't work it out.
It's a bit of both ends of the throat. A little bit scrappy now that Holmes is trying to...
Well, the nose has been cut badly.
Yeah. Animal instinct on when he wounded and had to fight
back. That's when he comes. Let's have a look back at that.
Going in there, Tom, some nice right uppercuts coming in from Holmes, and also Jack Kelly catching Holmes with some
all judges have got red again.
Yeah.
So Holmes is 2 weeks.
Yeah. And he came into it a little bit more than Jack Kelly. I wouldn't have said he won the round, but got into the fight a little bit more than he was in the previous round.
But he's a challenger, you've got to see more.
Rip that away from the champion. Keep doing that at the moment. Caught some nice punches from Holmes on the inside. Thanks for throwing that blow from the nose and the eye. Oh, it doesn't look too bad. Both looks are brilliant, Tom, don't get me wrong, but it doesn't look as too bad as far as cuts go. There's that blood on the back of the head.
The doctor's having a look at Kelly.
The doctor's having a long look at Kelly, by the way.
Yeah, but he's okay. But the doctor, it's the other round, the other corner. The doctor had a really good look, but I think they're going to let him go on.
It's because the blood's flowing into the eyes, Tommy.
Yeah, that's always the problem.
When they stop it, then it starts pouring straight in. That's what the doctor's looking at. You see the fact that the flow of blood's still constant. A shot and it's right there, right hand from Kelly.
Both could have been holding a punching as well.
Yeah.
Looking for that big right or big left that'll win them the fight. Because I don't think either of them wants 7 rounds of this. Or body shot again from Holmes.
Nice uppercut from Holmes with a right uppercut there on the inside as he came in close, working to the body, trying to get the right uppercut. And he goes again. Movement from Holmes then, so he stepped to the side and underneath Kelly's arm stand.
Kelly's doing more holding now, doesn't he?
Starting to feel the pace as well a little bit more.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of holding from Kelly.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's the only leaper when in
the third round. He goes again, holding.
Still got 4 to go, Tom. Kelly's just starting up. Trying to blow, he's just holding a lot more, like you said, Tom.
Yes, again.
And I think that's down to,
I think the referee's going to tell him in a moment. He's told
to
him.
Nice, holding again.
Yeah. That clinch, it's almost, I think that might be what's allowed. See, every time, it's just grabbing Holmes around the neck. It's definitely turned a little scruffy now.
Yeah, I mean, I think
they both took some punishment, to be fair.
I think that blood in the that's coming from the cut of Kelly is starting to disturb him a little bit now. Tommy, you keep seeing, he keeps dabbing away at it.
Both cornermen are going to have to do a lot of work now. The cut man. Let's see what happens. But let's have a little look back at some of the action there.
Good shot from Holmes, with the right hand over the top. Shots and uppercuts coming in from Holmes again.
Two red, one draw that round. said the three judges. That's better from Chad Kelly. And a good left from Kelly there. The pace, though, has been telling, hasn't it, for both of them?
Yeah, both guys, the big guys. Starting to feel the pace a bit more now, Tom. More so Kelly, I think, than Holmes, but... people need to remember is them big muscles need oxygen there.
Absolutely, all the time.
To feed them, Tom, to keep them going. And
oh, what a good
shot from Holmes.
Holmes had a great upper at first as he came into it. When you rush forward, you're putting yourself at risk.
Exactly. You're asking to walk on for one. Yeah. You can time it just right, Tom. I didn't think that was harder than he should come back there. Waving with the hands, but...
both doing a bit of holding there. This Chad Kelly's game though, isn't he? He is one tough guy.
He's still in the fight, Tom. Yeah.
Oh, good shot from him.
Good right hand over the top from
Hughes. Right hand there.
Kick himself after that one. You know, he left himself open and left himself vulnerable and he got caught with that right hand, Tom.
That's the best shot Kelly's thrown all night. Struggling with that blood though. He's having a word with both. Well done, Clive, get a grip. Well done. Well done, Clive, good referee. Good stuff from Holmes. When he works on the jab, Kelly, he's much better.
Jab, yeah. He just wants to tear up, he wants to be on the inside. The damage to Holmes is up there as well, Tom.
Be interesting to see what the Cupman can do. The American Cupman, Victor, is in the corner with Kelly, working hard at Kelly. Let's have a look back at some of the action there. Chad Kelly won that round. Two judges went Kelly, one went to Holmes.
Still in the fight, Tom?
Yep.
Still in the fight.
But he worked, you know when he works off the jab? When he works off the jab, he's far better, Kelly.
Yeah.
When he works off that jab.
He's not throwing it enough, though, is he?
No.
So when he throws it, he has success with it.
When he gets involved, he's worse. Keep him at a distance and work off the jab, he's better. Well, he's 3-1 down, Kelly, so he's got to do something special. Remember as well, he's used to the trigon ring in America, the triangle-shaped ring.
He's got no support as such, you know, he's got no home crowd support. He's doing well, Tom, you know, he's in the fight. He's not winning the fight, but...
Neutral corner wants a word. Oh, the rapids come loose. Yes. Counterpunch. not quite as frenetic now, is it? They're tiring both boxers.
Pace has slowed down.
Put a lot into them opening rounds.
Pace has slowed down a lot, hasn't it?
Absolutely. I think Kelly's better, but the slower pace, working off the jump. That's better. Kelly's been better there.
The man at home, is he? Let's check. Kelly puts on the pressure.
Changing stance, he didn't like that, Kelly. Good jab though, straight in, right on the bruise as well.
His pace seems to, like you said, Tom, seems to be suiting Kelly a lot better.
He's better at the slower pace.
He's getting his single shots in, jabs.
And yet he was probably the one that dictated the pace early doors.
Yeah, he was trying to take
right,
it. Yeah, he'd be better off getting staying on the back foot, boxing a bit more.
Let's have a look back at the highlights from that 2 minutes. Kelly then. All judges went to Kelly.
Well back in the fight now.
Well back,
well
in, the
back
fight.
In the fight. Well, like we're saying, Tom, I mean, hopefully he's got, well, hopefully he don't mean it in that way, but as he got onto the fan down, this pace is suiting him better, isn't it? The single shots.
We don't know, do we? We don't know what his corners have told him. Listen, yeah, this is what you've
this
got
is
to
what's
do.
Suiting you better.
And then he's worked at it.
Yeah, because he's showing with the judges and the scorecards. And I always got to look at it, maybe the judges are seeing it a little bit more cleanly when he's keeping the distance.
Well, then you do, don't you?
Yeah,
all that
grappling. When all, yeah, grappling and in fighting. You can't always see what's going on.
But this has been a grueling fight for both.
Both guys beating him, but am I right in saying Andy Holmes looks like he's, I don't know if that's jaw problems that he's got, but his mouth's wide open,
yeah,
gasping for air. Starting to feel the pace.
They're both about the same. 87.6 Holmes weighed in kilos, and 88.6 Chad Kelly. So there's not an awful lot.
And this, I'd be saying, Tom, this is this pace for me is suiting Kelly a lot more, especially when he gets them jabs going in. And then he ruins, well, it ruins it, but he crowds his work, doesn't he, when
see,
he wants to get in close.
What you'd like to see is work off that jab,
yeah,
and then
keep
back
up. Distance, yeah, keep
but what
distance.
He does, he brawls there, yeah, and ruins it.
And ruins it. And he just gets too close, can't get his shots off. Get his shots off.
I think they're that tired now. We could see a punch that could finish this.
Definitely. Yeah. For me, the guy, Tom, and it almost looks like he's feeling the pace a little bit more than he was earlier. Kelly just, it's a slower pace as well, Tom, so, you know, that's obviously suiting Kelly a lot better, being able to pick his punches. You know, he's not having to look for Holmes now. Holmes is coming on to win.
Oh, good shot on the left there from Kelly. Oh, good body shot from Holmes, and now holding. Again, when he does that body, he works that body well, Holmes.
Just missed with that right upper ball.
Oh,
got caught.
Oh,
he
shot
Holmes then with a good right hand. Right at the end of the bell, I think Holmes felt that one, Tom.
That, yeah, absolutely.
He's feeling the pace as well now. It's Anthony Holmes. This is where all that hard training and cardio.
This is when it gets you through.
This is where he needs it to kick in. Start to.
Highlights of that round, let's have a little look back. That round to Kelly, all judges that round to Kelly. Amazing, all judges have got Kelly there. I think he's won the last 3 rounds.
Yeah,
this is going to be close.
Three.
This could be all on the last round. Interesting, this is the way this is going to pan out.
Could take this, Tom, with this last round. If Holmes needs to give himself a kick here, and it's the last round if he wants to hold on to this title.
I think he'd have been told as well what he's got to do to him.
He needs a good round now, Holmes. Can he crawl his way back a little bit? Like I say, within the last three rounds, Tom, this pace has suited him, but Holmes needs to take him out.
See, if you're 4 rounds ahead, you can just back away and use the ring to get away from trouble. But he's that close, both of them are going to come with him in the final.
Oh, good shit. Holmes has just caught. Yeah. Get him on the way in. I think his legs held down by Holmes, with his legs were a little bit jelly like Tom.
They're running on empty at the moment, aren't they?
They brought everything into this fight, Tom. Fast pace, slowed the pace down, speeded it up again. Two big guys, good shot again from Holmes.
They're both out on the feet, look.
Good right hand from and Chad Kelly.
They're both feeling this pace. We've got a minute of the round to go.
Kelly just looking up at Ebb, sorry, Holmes just looking up at the clock. Then he's feeling the pace.
Good shot.
And again, he looks at the clock. He's waiting for that time to tick out. What he doesn't want to do, Tom, is a good shot from Holmes.
Good shot.
He needs to finish the round strong, Tom. Take the judge's eye for the last round. He's the champion, let's not forget. So he
and he has up. Come.
Yeah, he's come back a bit now.
Come back a little bit in this round.
Well, like we say, Tommy, it all depends on how them judges are seeing it. Holmes has come back well in this last round, though. He's needed to.
Oh, good shot again. These guys have given everything. There's nothing in the tank left.
And he needed to pick it up a little bit there if he wants to hold on to his title, Andy Holmes, but coming forward a bit more now. Not always successful, but he's putting the pressure on. Nice inside work though from Kelly. Oh. Ooh, nice counter punch from Holmes as Kelly comes in.
They're actually running on fumes, aren't they?
Since then, yeah. Since then.
There it is.
That's a close one if you're listening.
Brilliant.
That's a close
one. That's
a
really tough one to call.
You can't argue whichever way this goes, Tom.
No. They have given everything.
And that's good to see, Tom, you know.
Wow, what a fight. Let's have a look at that, which I think might have been a better round for him.
Yeah. He needed that last round. Kelly was just starting to crawl his way back.
Because it looked like he might have been level up.
Yeah, exactly, Tom. Yeah. And he's,
so that last round could be the decider.
Yeah. And he's the champion, so I think. I think he's just crawled it, clawed it back there, Tom.
Maybe.
I think he's just crawled it back there. Pressure on, some nice. Successful at times, but then walking onto some shots. Some time, so
that's just that's how it, the Kelly was. The look about him when they interviewed him. That look about him. There's no mug.
His great debut over here, Tom.
Yeah, in front of the partisan.
Exactly. He's given a good account of himself. He's handled himself well. He's got no support. Yeah, he's, you know, he stuck it out to the end, and he came back into the fight, Tom. You know, winning the last three rounds.
Two absolute warriors.
Yeah, we'll have to see how the judges see this last one.
Right, let's go and find exactly what the judges have said. Here's Lance Murdoch.
Blood, sweat and tears, ladies and gentlemen. Big round of applause for both of these warriors. Ladies and gentlemen, in the first ever BKB, BYB cross promotion world title clash. After seven rounds of blood curdling action, we consult the judges' scorecards. After much deliberation, it is a draw.
You know what, though, Tom? That's fair, to be fair.
Keeps the belt.
For both of these fighters, please.
He keeps the belt, champion keeps the belt, yeah. And that was a typical example, Tom, there.
I don't think neither of them deserved to lose.
No, exactly. And Kelly, even though he was in the fight, hadn't quite done enough to take the title away.
Yeah. And so, that's the key. That was the final thing. That was the little bit of difference there. A draw, but he hadn't done enough to take it.
The title. himself after that now, Tom. Can he get a good account of himself, don't get me wrong. But when he watches that back, he might have been, if he just put that little bit more pressure on in that last round, he, you know, he's got a draw out of it, he could have just nicked it.
Let's now have a little look here, because Anthony Holmes is going to talk to Glenn McCauley, but we were chatting off air there, and I said to you, I would not be surprised at the draw.
Yeah, that's fair, Tom.
Because I think if you... He did enough to get him back into the fight.
Yeah.
Had he been the champion, he would have won it. But he didn't do enough to take it. And that's the key. He did not do that. So the champion keeps the belt.
Yeah. And that keeps the belt.
Yeah. But if ever there was a Miami rematch, that's it, isn't it?
That's the one.
That's the one to go out to Miami and.
Would mind commentating on that one over in Miami?
Well, I'll be there. No, you're right.
Give me a suitcase.
Well, here we go. Glenn McCrory, I think, he's going to be talking to both fighters, because that was epic.
Yeah, it was a draw, so absolutely. Both fighters are going to give their views.
Epic. I mean, they've got nothing left, have they, either?
No, they give it all there. Two big guys as well, and, nothing, you know, they've trained hard. And that's where it's paid off, Tom.
Absolutely. Well, Glenn's just sitting them both down to have a chat. Right, let's cross to Glenn McCrory.
Well, let me say, boys, Anthony and Chad, that was a very, very tough fight, and I think a fair decision. What do you think, Anthony?
Yeah, I caught a shot in first round. I couldn't see out that eye. My left was blurry as fuck. And,
Chad, what was it like for you? Visit to England, and you get to draw for the world title.
It's been shit. This is the best part of the whole trip, right? But no. I mean, it was a close fight. I thought I edged it out, but apparently not, so we're going to have to run it back sometime. Hopefully in the Trigon, baby.
So what about that? Get to America and go and have a go at a triangle.
I have to go to the fucking embassy, mate. See if I can get over there, but... Yeah, I'd love to run it back, so I got John into his game. I'm fucking... No excuse, he turned up before, like Whitewood. Caught me first round. I'm fucking struggling to see that left eye all the way through. So I got cut, and then I got caught. Fighting his game, not been neat, been hesitant, and it cost me the fight really.
You never really seemed to get your boxing going or get into a rhythm, it always seemed a little bit scrappy.
Yeah, all the way through. Everything went out window, what I've been working on. Too hesitant, just waiting for his big right all the time. But it is what it is, do what I'll do, run it back.
Chad, you started a little bit slowly, but you got back into the fight, and you know, you're doing really well towards the end.
Yeah, I was expecting a different fighter, I guess. I thought more he was going to keep his distance and move around, and he just kept trying to tie me up, so it changed how I was working. But yeah, I feel like, I don't know, I feel good.
Do you feel you suited more for the triangle ring?
Yeah, I mean, the clinch game is... where I really dominate, and I mean, you can see I had a little trouble adapting there, but yeah.
Well, listen, boys, you've put on some great entertainment. It was a bloody battle and a tough battle, but well done.
Cheers, lads. Cheers, thank you. Thank you.
There you go, Glenn McCrory talking to both those warriors. Absolutely brilliant, you know, super stuff.